What I show you today is not the only way to install the membranes, but it's one way that works really well. I'm actually not Ecological Building Systems. I have a company for supply and fit or to install the airtightness membranes. So I rely on good materials and an effective way to install them. And we have a window here, a mock-up. So if it is a smaller window like that size on a building site, I install the membrane straight over the window. And the way I do it is I have a system that I fit the membrane on one side first, pull it over to the far side, pull it, but not too hard, and then I pick a point the opposite of the first two fixings in the middle. So what I get here is a triangle, and I have two more triangles here again, and I pull the corner, pull it there, and that really is half the battle. And then, you know, I step back, see if I'm happy. Put in a few more staples. And the tighter the membrane, the less creases I get, the easier really it is to work with. On a window, there are basically now there's two ways to cut the opening. One would be to exit just from corner to corner, and another way would be a cut down the middle and then bottom and top. Both ways have an advantage and a disadvantage, so I show you both. So that would be the one way, just with an X. And the other way, down the middle, left, right. If you exit, you have the advantage that you can use most of the membrane to cover your reveals. Like here. And the deeper the reveal, the more, you know, you actually make use of the membrane that you have anyway. On some of my first jobs, I used much more membrane than I calculated. And I was wondering how that is. Do I have so many cutoffs, or where's the problem? And then I measured the reveals, and I would say in a typical one-off house, the reveals alone can be 30 to 40 square meter, which is half a roll of membrane. It's quite a lot, actually. So you just, you know, calculate it in. Now, once I stapled on the membrane, I just cut it back flush here, down there, and the top, and I have the bottom, the sides, and the top covered, but I also have those little triangles here left over. So what I do now is I'll actually cut an additional little piece to fill it in into those triangles. So just like an insert, you could say. That's it. And now you attempted to cut the membrane kind of flush with the existing membrane. If you do so, it can be harder to tape it. If I try to tape that overlap now, there's a bit of a risk that you know, I somehow catch the edge with the tape and I get something kind of funny, like, you know, a fold or crease, and you know, it just doesn't really work then anymore. So instead, I like to turn around, to turn the membrane a little bit over the edge, staple it down there, and trim it off after. And that means the membrane is nicely fixed in place and it's easy to tape then. So that's the one scenario. Now if I cut it down the way I've done it here, the disadvantage is I only cover two reveals of the window. But more often than not, the cutoff I have fits pretty perfect into the opposite side, so I'm not losing materials. And it's really down to personal choice, but I prefer not to fiddle around with little triangle bits in the corner. So I prefer to have the long strip, so I always cut it down left, right, fold it in, use the off cut, put it into the bottom, put it into the top, and that's it. And again, I don't trim it off flush here, but I bring it a little bit around corner. And cut it off then. If I cut a membrane on top of an existing membrane, I kind of pull the membrane into the knife rather than pushing the knife into the membrane, if that makes sense. And that way you can cut it off without damaging the membrane underneath. Okay, that's the membrane. Now we come to the tapes. There's a tape specifically for windows and it has a split section on the back. It's like the normal tape that you use for taping the joints, the overlaps, but it has a split section, and that split section is about 12.5 mil, half an inch. What comes to your mind when you think half an inch? What's a typical product on site that has half an inch?
Plasterboard.
So, this split section is also the minimum that Proclima recommends to tape onto any other element. So you should tape at least half an inch onto the window or onto any adjacent building elements. Now, I could use the normal tape for it, no problem. Technically, that's correct. Yeah, you know, technically nothing speaks against it, but I have a bit of a challenge here now. I want to tape 12.5 mil onto the face of the window. So first you have to kind of judge, like, you know, where is the 12.5 mil, or you have to mark it. And the next challenge is you kind of get stuck in the reveal when you try to position the tape. I do air tightens for more than 20 years, so I kind of got a hang of it how to use the tapes, but I still use the one with the split section. It's just so much faster, it makes sense, and it's also safer for me that I don't tape too far onto the window, because 12.5 mil is the minimum, but it's also the maximum, because the client won't be pleased if he sees the blue tape until the end of, you know, the life of the building. I mean, they're good looking tapes, but like so with the split section, you know, I can freely maneuver here, bring it into position, stick it on. I have a guide, 12.5 mil. I know this will be covered at a later stage by the plasterboard, and I know that Proclima will be happy with me because it's 12.5 mil onto the window. And the most important tool after the knife is your blue press fix. So any tape that you install, give it a good squeeze, a good rub, and make sure you always right into the corners, sharp into the corners. Don't leave it kind of roundish. If you leave it roundish, just peel this one off, right in, give it a good rub, and that's it. If you install the tape okay, I exaggerate a bit, but if the corner isn't sharp and if you just stick the tape on, like, let's say like that, what's gonna happen? Yeah, there are gaps, that's the worst, but then the dry liner who does the gypsum board in the reveal, he just, you know, he would just push in into the tape, and that's when you rip the seal and all of a sudden you get leaks that you shouldn't have. Oop, that's too quick. Okay, so that's the easy bit. I normally start with the more tricky parts of a job. I always like to have the hard part out of the way and then move on to the easy. And that would be the corners of the windows. If I have a situation like this, where the window is nice and flush in the reveals and there's very little gap in between the window and the actual reveal, I actually pre-cut my own corners. So I just use a strip of the tape, split the small section, peel off one of those strips, fold it over 90 degrees, fold the corner, peel off the second liner, and I have a preformed 3D corner that I just slot in here now. And that's actually like, you know, fast, efficient, looks neat, and is totally airtight. When I started doing airtightness, we only had two products. It was a paper membrane and a glue. And we did everything with the glue and the membrane. At that time, I had hairs to here, down to there, like long hair. And after a full day on a building site with a bucket of glue, I had the glue everywhere. Like, I looked like a pig, really. Like. So the first questions came up, can we not make it somehow easier? Can they not develop a tape? You know, aren't there kind of tidier ways of doing airtightness? And from there on, Proclima developed the whole product range, and I think they have in it around 200 different products. They're too many to even, you know, show them or count them on one day. So if that is too much work for you, you can actually buy preformed 3D corners in a pack of five, and you just take, or four, you just take them out, slot them in, and that's it. So that's the corners. Now, most of the time we have a situation where you have a gap between the window and the reveal. So in those scenarios, the easiest way to seal the corner is a strip of tape and have a way holding it with the two middle finger and the index finger, and you bring it in to the corner. Well, that's actually better here, isn't it? And just slightly, you know, just leave it a fraction longer than you actually need it. Just a little bit around the corner. You know, if I put a number on it, I would say 3-4 mil. peel off the liner. Whoop, that didn't work. Use the press fix. Make sure it's in good and tight, and do the same from the far side. And the way the tape overlaps 2 times 3-4 mil is a total of 6 to 8 mil, and it's completely airtight, and we never had a problem there. Having said all that, the most efficient way would be to pre-apply the tapes to the outside of the window before you install the window. But I'd say that's like we get that maybe 2% of all the windows. Most windows are installed and then taped. But if I was a window fitter, I would pre-tape them, install them, and then you can tape it to the outside of the window, and there's no need to tape it to the face of the window. That makes sense. Thank you.